Good afternoon, Rabbi Tai. The question is asked, how often does a person have to check his mezuzot and tefillin after he buys them? First of all, right, tells the Shulchan Aruch, Siman Lamed Tet tells us that when a person buys tefillin, he has to buy them from somebody who's expert in writing these things, right? Somebody who's a mumche. If he buys from somebody who's not expert, somebody who's just a regular dealer or some kind of merchant, right, whatever, he's not expert in that. So the truth is that he has to check that tefillin after he buys it to make sure. He has to open it up and see what's in there. If it's kosher, it's everything is good, everything is nice, right? So therefore, first of all, a person has to make sure in the beginning that his tefillin is kosher, either by buying it from an expert or checking it himself, having it checked by an expert. But once he does that, right, now we have a chazakah, we have a presumption that the tefillin is kosher. So the question is, once he does that, later on, how often does he check, have to check the tefillin? So the answer is, Rabotai, that we have two opinions actually in the Gemara, right? One says you have to check twice in 7 years, but there's also another opinion in the Gemara brought down that you never have to check them at all. Once you buy them, that's it, right? They're good forever for the whole world. Actually, you find in the Chuvot of the Geonim that they write that even 40 or 50 years, a person has tefillin, and in the end, in the beginning, he checked everything was good, as we said, right? He ascertained it. Once that's done, he can go for a lifetime, right? He can have that tefillin, no problem with that. It doesn't need to be checked whatsoever. Even though there is also, right, a custom of the medaktekim, right? People who are balei nefesh, people who are more stringent, they like to check the tefillin once a year, you know, on Chodesh Elul before Rosh Hashanah. This is a stringency. This is a custom that some people do. But according to halacha, the truth is, right, the halacha is, according to the Shulchan Aruch, learns from the Rambam this way, right? The Rambam writes also like this. That does not need checked forever. Once it's ascertained that it's kosher forever. When it comes to mezuzah, by the way, it's not like that, right? We've seen in Gemara, Masechet Yomam, that a mezuzah has to be checked twice every 7 years. As we said, right, there's also an opinion like that regarding tefillin as well. But here, the halakha is, the truth is, according to Shulchan Aruch, that it has to be checked twice in 7 years, right? So the question is, why is there a difference between mezuzah and tefillin? What's the discrepancy over here? Why this one never needs to be checked and this one needs to be checked? So the answer is, Rabotai, teaches the Rambam that the reason why tefillin do not need to be checked is because they're covered, right? Covering the box that it's in, it's sewn up, it's put in a box, and it's sewn up, and therefore, right, there's no air that gets in there. It's airtight, basically, more or less airtight. So therefore, right, there's no issue there of the tefillin, the parchment, rotting or becoming, right, moldy because of the humidity, the moisture of the air, all kinds of things like this. And this is the reason why tefillin never have to be checked. But when it comes to mezuzah, which are, you know, at least in those days, they were pretty much in the open more. They were not covered so much, right? So therefore, in a case like that, when the mezuzah is not covered, so we are concerned about all kinds of rotting going on there. And this is the reason why the mezuzah needs to be checked, according to halacha, twice in 7 years. There's also something interesting we find, right, that says the Shulchan Aruch and Siman Lamed Tet, another thing, which is that what about a person who has a spare tefillin, right? A lot of people have a spare. You know how it is, right? Sometimes you have a guest that comes from somewhere else. You want to give him your tefillin to put on. He didn't bring his tefillin from the house. Or let's say, for instance, right, you're going to now get them checked, and therefore, right, you want to put on the spare tefillin. You want to have something in the house to put on. Or let's say, right, he had one tefillin from his childhood, and then he decided to buy a better pair of tefillin, like something more unusual, right? Something more mehudar, something more kosher. So therefore, he bought another pair. So now he has a spare sitting in the closet. So the question is like this, right? Does that spare also, what's halakha with that? Does it need to be checked once in a while? Or also we say that it never needs to be checked once it was ascertained that it's kosher. So it says the Shulchan Aruch over there, in Siman Lamed Tet, that the spare tefillin, which is not used often, needs to be checked twice in 7 years, like the mezuzah. So the question is why, right? Why would you make a differentiation between the spare and the regular one? So the truth is, right, that logically speaking, there should be no difference. Because according to Rambam, right, the whole point is that they're both covered with a box and it's sewn up. There's no air coming in there. So therefore, what the difference is, it doesn't make if I use it sometimes or I use it all the time or every day. What difference does it should that make? Logically speaking, there's no differentiation. So therefore, right, we have to go back into the Rishonim and see a little bit the source of this whole idea. So the first of all, right, what Maran says, the Shulchan Aruch, that it has to be checked twice in 7 years, he gets this from Rabbeinu Yerucham, one of the Rishonim, right? He writes over there, Rabbeinu Yerucham, that if a person is not using it on a daily basis, once in a while, so then he has to check it twice in 7 years. He says it's very simple. But the truth is, as we said, right, the logic there is not clear. Why would that be any different from any other tefillin? So the answer is, Rabotai, if you look in the Rambam writes what the reason is, right? He says that the reason is because, as we already mentioned, Rambam says the reason we don't have to check the tefillin is because it's covered. So therefore, according to Rambam, the point is that if it's not covered, the tefillin, right, it has a hole or it's open, it's not sewn up, it's opened up. So in a case like that, the tefillin has to be checked twice in 7 years because the air gets in and it could rot. And therefore, right, can ruin the letters. One of the letters could be blotted out or erased or whatever, right? Or the parchment can get ruined there, whatever, worn out and rip, all kinds of things like this. So says the Rambam, the whole point is, right, that the reason we don't check the tefillin is because it's covered. So then, right, what do we see from there? That if it's not covered, it needs to be checked. Just like the mezuzah, as we mentioned, right? So what's the whole idea over here? The whole idea is like this, right? That it seems to be, according to this, what we just mentioned here, the Rambam, that what Rabbeinu Yerucham is talking about, a person must check the tefillin twice every 7 years. If it's a spare tefillin, he's talking about a tefillin which is open. What does that mean? Right? I guess in those days, nowadays it's not like this. But in those days, when they had a spare, right, it's very possible that they didn't close it, they didn't sew it up, it wasn't sewn up. It was just left there kind of like open there, whatever. You know, and then whatever they needed to use it, they would sew it up and, you know, make it tight, everything, and then they would put it on. But since they're not using it on a daily basis, they had no reason to keep it closed all the time. So therefore, it must be, right, Rabbi Rucham is talking about a case like that, according to what the Rambam said. So what does that mean? Practically speaking, right, that our tefillin nowadays, which are usually all of them sewn up and closed, so therefore, even if he has a spare, he doesn't really need to check them every twice in 7 years. It's just like the tefillin that he uses every day. There's no difference. What difference does it make? Whether it's sitting in the closet or it's being put on every day, there's no practical difference over there. So therefore, Rabbi Tzai, halacha comes out that nowadays, since our tefillin are usually closed, the halacha would be that even a tefillin which is a spare, is not used all the time, does not to be checked twice in 7 years. No such a halacha like that. So, but this right now comes up a novel idea here as well. What does that mean? In our times, right, the custom is, as you know, when you go to buy a mezuzah, the sofer, right, or whoever, the merchant that sells you the mezuzah, what does he do? He covers it up with cellophane, right? It's nice, closes it up good, ties it up nice, and therefore, right, the truth is, in our times, the mezuzah is also closed up. It's also airtight, more or less, right? So therefore, our mezuzot, which are usually closed up airtight, and also there's another cover which is put on top of that, right, the mezuzah cover. So those two things now make the mezuzah pretty much totally immune to air altogether. So therefore, according to that, Rabotai, comes out, we have a new here, a chidush, right? Novel idea in halakha, that a person who has mezuzah like that, most people, which are closed up and sealed up, airtight, and cellophane, there's no air going in there. So therefore, he doesn't need to have to check the mezuzah either twice in 7 years. He will never have to check it. Why? Because it's like the tefillin. Just like the tefillin, the reason we don't check it is because it's covered. So the same thing would also apply to the mezuzah. So therefore, if a person has a hard time removing the mezuzah and checking it for some reason, whatever, it's not easy for him to do such a thing like that. Maybe he doesn't have somebody there to check it, whatever it is. So therefore, we can rely on this, right, according to halacha, and not need to check the mezuzot at all. Why? Because they're airtight and covered. And that's the reason why, Baruch Hashem, that we can rely on that. Baruch Adonai Le'olam, Amen, Amen, Chazak U'Baruch.